Were you curious about the long-awaited sequel to Top Gun? Now that it is finally here, Top Gun Maverick has unraveled thrilling and highly fascinating facts regarding the legendary FA-18 Super Hornet. If you are a mad fan of the FA-18 and the new movie, then we have got something super exciting for you. The FA-18 has been making headlines over the last few months with the release of Top Gun Maverick. One of the reasons is because the Mission Impossible actor, who is also prominently known for performing his own stunts, is none other than Tom Cruise. He is definitely one of Hollywood's greatest actors, and when it comes to making the acting appear super realistic on screen, nobody can beat Tom Cruise. That is why he wanted the actors to portray the role of pilots in real FA-18 fighter jets. This was done so that actors could get the feel of operating a fighter jet under extreme gravitational forces. Now, this is something that makes the entire movie a center of attraction for the viewers. The usage of fighter jets like the FA-18 has made the movie one of the most highly anticipated military movies in over a decade. Are you ready? Strap yourself in as we count down the top 10 FA-18 Super Hornet amazing facts that will blow your mind. Number 10. It was originally named the YF-17. The origins of the Super Hornet began with the entry of its then-manufacturer, McDonnell Douglas, into the Lightweight Fighter Program, LWF, of the US Air Force. A competition to produce a smaller, cheaper fighter to complement the F-15 Eagle, what was to become the first Hornet, was designated the YF-17. Although it lost the LWF competition to the F-16 Fighting Falcon, the YF-17 was selected for the new Naval Fighter Attack Experimental Program, VFAX. In enlarged form, the FA-18 Hornet was adopted by the US Navy and United States Marine Corps to replace the A-7 Corsair II and F-4 Phantom II, complementing the more expensive F-14 Tomcat. This design, conceived as a small and lightweight fighter, was scaled up to the Boeing FA-18 EF Super Hornet, which is similar in size to the F-15. Number 9. Navy bound. Though losing out to the F-16 in the LWF program, the Hornet proved its worth when, in 1975, it bagged the contract for the Navy Air Combat Fighter competition, as the Navy saw the need for a bigger, more robust airframe capable of carrier-based operations to complement and later replace the costly FA-14. Number 8. Build it bigger, build it badder. With the aging and expensive F-14 fleet being retired, the US Navy turned to the FA-18 to fill the gap. Though already in service, the order to replace the FA-14 required the Hornet to evolve to match the range, load, and performance specifications of the old Tomcat, and meet the requirements to be the new naval frontline fighter and interceptor. Number 7. Size and efficiency count. The improved FA-18, now going by the name Super Hornet, was bigger, by 4 feet overall in length, had 25% more wing area, and added 30% fuel capacity, resulting in 40% longer flight and mission times. These improvements were a result of redesigned surfaces, air intakes greatly improving aerodynamics, and handling and fuel efficiency. Number 6. Easy to fly, easy to repair. By design, the FA-18 was envisioned to have easy maintenance and fewer repairs to allow for more flight time. Years after its debut, this proved to be true, as compared to other aircraft, Super Hornets have required less maintenance, 75% more efficient than its FA-14 predecessor in terms of maintenance per 1 hour of flight time, saving the US taxpayer a pretty penny. Still extremely dangerous. Despite its age and the rise of the fifth-generation jet fighters as depicted in Top Gun Maverick, the FA-18 Super Hornet continues in its formidable role of a frontline naval fighter. This established reputation, in fact, has led to further developments on the aircraft, as the delays and costly flaws in its supposed replacement, the FA-35, have made the Super Hornet a much cheaper alternative. Number 4. FA-18 is a refueler tanker. While its main purpose is a fighter, the Super Hornet embodies its general classification as a multi-role aircraft by having the capability to act as a fuel tanker. By adding an external refuel system and installing 5 external fuel tanks, the aircraft can be configured as an airborne tanker. Number 3. Blue Angels Choice. The Blue Angels aircraft exhibition team has long been associated with the FA-18, starting in 1986 when they began using the original Hornet in line with their 40th year anniversary. The Blue Angels traded in their high-mileage legacy FA-18A, FA-18C, and FA-18D Hornets at the end of 2020, as the jets had worked hard and their retirement was long overdue. The Blue Angels currently fly FA-18E and FA-18F Super Hornets, Rhinos. Number 2. Growler Adaption and Overseas Customers. In 2008, the EA-18G Growler joined the Navy's aircraft fleet. A Super Hornet derivative, the EA-18G provides tactical jamming and electronic protection for U.S. and Allied forces, delivering full-spectrum airborne electronic attack capability along with the targeting and self-defense capabilities of the Super Hornet. The FA-18 is flown by a number of Allied countries, such as Canada, Finland, Spain, Switzerland, Australia, and others. Number 1. Constantly upgraded and still cheaper than 5G fighters. As the fifth generation of fighter aircraft in the U.S. inventory has shown successive delays and cost overruns, the Department of Defense has authorized a Block 3 upgrade of the FA-18 fleet that would enable it to fly combat operations for at least another decade. With the staggering and eye-watering running costs of the 5G fighters, the FA-18 operates at $11,000 per hour compared to the F-22 at $33,000 per hour and the F-35 at $28,000 per hour. It seems Tom Cruise got a bargain for Top Gun, with a reported $10,462 per hour. Well, there you have it, the FA-18 Super Hornet Top 10 Amazing Facts That Will Blow Your Mind. Did you enjoy watching Top Gun Maverick? What are your thoughts on the FA-18? Which aircraft is better? Leave a comment below. With that said, share this video with aviation geeks around the world, and keep watching and loving our videos. Stay tuned for more, and until next time, fly safe.